International Sudan Aviation Authority says the Juba airport will be closed over the weekends starting from the 22nd of August 2015 to the 30th of April 2016. The move is to allow renovation. The closure will be for 24 hours on Saturdays and Sundays. All flight agencies have been asked to schedule their operations according to this arrangement. The measure was announced during a press conference led by Captain David Martin Hassan, the Undersecretary in the Ministry of Transport, Roads and Bridges in South Sudan's capital Juba on Thursday, 23rd July 2015.
To complete the work within a contracted time of 30 months. Okay. We want relief. We want anybody to use the airport as he like. They have no problem. It is us. Cancel all the 2 days. The airport will not finish in time. It will take you another 3 years. So it is a matter of judgment and logic to us ourselves. Do we need the work to finish in the prescribed time? Is entirely our need as a government, as the people. If I tell you a secret, this runway is supposed to be closed not even for relief or for anything. You will not know this. It is a disaster for accident anytime.
Major concerns were raised during a press conference, especially the impact on relief operations. As much as the aid in South Sudan is delivered by air, further medical evacuation was a key concern. The Undersecretary Hassan says it is up to the relief suppliers to schedule their operations accordingly.
We have 5-7 days a week. We have taken 2 days. The operation is 5 days. I don't think there is any effect on the relief. I think those people who are bringing the relief, the planes, they know better than us. But everybody fights for his own. The relief, he doesn't care on your airport whether it is repair or not. He wants you to leave it to him like that. Will you accept it? The answer is no. It is us to tell him no. We close these days for the repair. It is accepted worldwide. I am a tarfid dunya. 25 years in my life, even Heathrow Airport. In the United States, NOTAM means notice to the air crew. Once they decide that the work is going on, even a simple work, nobody can change it. It is you, the operator. Whether you are a relief or an airline, you change your program to meet my requirement. I am the authority because I'm making it for the favor of my country. So this is what I want to clarify. The decision to close for 2 days is okay.
Song Ying, the deputy manager of the business department of China Abba Engineering Company, contracted to build a new runway, says they face major setbacks in their work. These setbacks include the delay payment of instruments and airlines that do not obey rules put in place to secure a timely operation. He further says that only helicopters are allowed to land and take off during the weekend, but if requested in time.
During the construction at Saturday and Sunday in the future, first of all, we will provide, before we get into the construction area, we will provide you the area that indicate some emergency landings or taking off for the helicopters only. And before we enter in the construction. So, which means if there's some emergency, the helicopters can use the runway for taking off and landing, but not for the fixed wing. But if we can get a prior notification, like 1 or 2 days before, such as Thursday or Friday, if we have been noticed by the airport authority, we will not have the construction during the Saturday and Sunday and provide the runway for the operation of the such as militaries or reliefs or emergency landings.
The People's Liberal Party has raised concern about the delayed completion of the construction work at Juba International Airport. not only the new runway, but also the new airport terminal, which was supposed to be completed for South Sudan's independence on the 9th July 2011, but hasn't been completed up to now. Describing the airport as the face of the nation, Peter Mayen of the People's Liberal Party says delays in completing the construction work is damaging the country's image. He says there is an urgent need for the constructors to account for the delays. For the Niles, I am Simon Bingo in Juba.